We are inside Florence Indian Mound Museum, tiny little museum. Right here under the bridge, there's an Indian mound that, for the most part, has been destroyed except for one mound. And we are in here looking at the display. It goes through all the different periods of history that the Indians were here.
The immensity of the structure is almost overwhelming, considering the primitive methods used for its construction. The mound stands 43 feet tall, with a base of over 71,000 square feet and a flat top 145 feet in length.
People often ask me sometimes, Brother Tom, how did they build that thing? They did it with white oak baskets.
And it was a very time-consuming process. It was built by probably one basket at a time full of dirt from the surrounding area.
It's important because it's one of the few woodland ceremonial centers in the southeast.
Well, this mound is a flat-top mound, and that's typical of ceremonial mounds, and people would gather there for the ceremonies.
I think that it was celebrations, time of the green corn. That's the very, very special time for the Southeastern peoples, the Choctaw, the Chickasaw, the Creek, and the Cherokee, the time of the green corn, a birth of maybe of a child.
They lived around the mound, and the mound was surrounded by a palisade.
The woodland cultures did not have palisades or enclosures for protection.
We really don't know. I've heard so many variations of that, why the wall was there. It was something probably lost in time because there's too many variations of it.
So far, there is no evidence of burials in the mound, but some believe that the base may contain a central tomb with the remains of a revered dignitary.
I don't know that anyone's ever inhabited it. I really don't. But speaking to my grandmother's people, from other mounds, of stuff like the Great Serpent Mound and places like that, they never showed any activity that I've been aware of.
There is also no evidence for a structure atop the mound or within the boundaries of the wall.
Over 90% of the content of woodland mounds is mystery.
To me, it is a very, very spiritual place. And I will tell you right now, all of the native people that have been here will tell you the same thing.
Outside the walled mound, there is evidence of village dwellings, the same woodland age as the mound. This area was rich in natural resources that proved essential to the Native Americans. Forests furnished trees for firewood and building materials. Nuts, berries, and wild game provided abundant food. Woodland Indians were skilled potters, creating beautifully decorated ceramic vessels. They used natural clays, adding pebbles and sand. These vessels were used to cook, store, and serve their foods. They also developed the bow and arrow, which allowed for better hunting and protection. Limestone formations containing chert nodules were so readily available that no quarrying was necessary.
There is a lot of this Fort Payne shirt that's here, and it was very good to make all kind of arrowheads, spear points, hoes, tools of all sorts.
Fishing was good too. Spearing and hooking of fish, we both took place.
Freshwater creeks and streams cut through this land. The Tennessee River, known as the River That Sings, was the lifeblood for these early people, providing a means of easy transportation and an abundance of fish and mussels. Mussel shells were used in a variety of ways, including scrapers for hollowing out logs to be made into dugout canoes.
They had the river here. They had this fantastic fertile land here at Wimpenny.
No longer were these natives primarily hunters and gatherers. The moderate climate and rich soils allowed farming of sunflowers, corn, beans, squash, maize, and other vegetables.
I just think it was just a paradise, and most of the people do. My grandmother's people believe it was.
The Florence Mound stands today as a shrine, shrouded by an ancient aura that continues to baffle attempts to define its reason for being and its true place in the history of a forgotten people.
If all these stories fall silent, who will teach our children? If you don't do things like Florence, Alabama is doing by preserving this beautiful, beautiful man, where will it end?
These are animal bone needles.
Is this all the stuff they found here, Nathan? Is this all the stuff they found here?
I think so. Lots of pottery. Look at that pottery right there.
Yeah, it's called a double knotted pot. And then number two is a water bottle. It's a water bottle. Huh. Water bottles come a long way, haven't they?
Yeah.
They're something pot, number three. It's a bear pot. Looks like a bear. Mound bowl, black film, water bottle. Four. That's cool. I like that one. Frog. It's a frog. What's it? F-G? F-G? F-E-G?
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 Yeah.
Small decoration.
We are going to take you up the mound now, and hopefully we won't pass out doing it. Where are you? I did. You're on video. And we are at the top. This little mound of dirt right in the middle of all this industry. Interesting little place. It's $5 to get in for adults. I think kids are free. Bunch of barges parked out of here. Off to the side. We're just feet from the dam. On the other side of those trees. In the middle of all this industry is a little piece of grass. That's thousands upon thousands of years old.